Hello, this is Dr. Antin from RD Physics, and this is the DIY audio channel. There isn't a lot the DIY person can do with headphones, but DSP is one of those. So in this video we will address what kind of DSP or equalizing you can do to headphones, and I'll be sharing a couple of files that I've made for these two headphones. And also I want to address the claim that frequency response is all that matters for headphones. And if there is a problem with the frequency response, EQ will fix it. So let's get started. This is based on computers, so you need a computer as your signal source. And then you have two options. You can either have system-wide EQ using Equalizer APO and perhaps the piece user interface, if you like that. Or you can use a plugin for your favorite music player. Now, having a system-wide EQ is nice because it affects all programs you're using, but I've had some issues with laptops and their OEM drivers, and when disabling the drivers, then the normal functionality of the laptop is impaired. So the system I'm using instead is, I have FUBAR 2000 as my music player, and I use the Math Audio headphone EQ plugin for it. And that way, it only affects FUBAR 2000. Now you can find preset EQ files online for most headphones actually. What I found with these Sennheiser HD800S headphones is that the preset EQ found online is a bit too harsh. It adds a bit too much brightness to the sound. So I've tweaked it a little bit, and I'm sharing the Math Audio headphone EQ preset files. So if you have either these headphones or the Koss Porta Pro, check the description for links for the files. So is equalizing all you really need to make headphones sound perfect? Well, they can certainly improve things a lot. Even for high quality headphones like the Sennheiser HD800S here, it brought out some new detail and added a little bit of brightness to the sound. And that's a positive change in my opinion. Of course, making big changes to the sound takes some time to get used to. For cheap headphones like these Koss Porta Pros, EQ can really help things and make them really sound good, even at a low price point. So is it simply a matter of downloading some preset files and you're good to go? Well, not necessarily. Like I mentioned, for these headphones, I had to tweak the EQ a bit. And we got to remember that the EQ files found online are obtained using a measurement head and aiming at a flat frequency response. But all of our ears are physically different, and a flat frequency response may not be what we actually want. And also the recordings that we listen to vary, the type of music varies. So the presets are a good starting point, but you should try to tweak them also, because it's, you know, free of cost. You can always revert back if you don't like the changes. So are there any downsides to processing the signal? Well, there could be some artifacts from filtering, such as pre-echo, and you could get added distortion from excessive bass boost. But really, as long as it sounds better to you, then that's all that matters, right? If you have either of these headphones, maybe you find the files that I'm sharing useful, and hopefully you are now interested in applying DSP and at least giving it a try, because it could be the only thing you need for your headphones. All right, everybody, stay tuned for our next video where I will justify why it's okay to spend $4,000 on headphones. Happy listening moments.